Hello students. So in the previous class, in this chapter, that is matter around is pure, we were talking about that of the separating technique students, and we have seen a lot of a separating technique, including that what are the separating process that we are going to use in separating that of two different solid from each other. And we had completed and understood that what are the process that we are going to use to separate the two solid component, as well as we have also studied that what are the different processes that we are going to use to separate the two different components, including the solid and that of the liquid. Means how can you separate the when solid and the liquid are present in the form of a mixture. So what are the method that we are going to use here, students? So we have used evaporation, then we have also used the process of filtration, then we have seen the process of centrifugation, then we have seen the process of a chromatography. We have seen that with the help of the chromatography paper, we are going to separate the components from each other, and as well as we are going to separate the mixtures through the process of a distillation. So process of a distillation, in that process we have seen the students that normally in the process of evaporation we can separate the solid from the liquid easily, in which the liquid will get evaporated, so we cannot get the liquid. But in case of a distillation, we will get that of the liquid by first of all by heating it, and then again it is by cooling it in the condenser. Okay, so in the condenser, when you cool it, what will happen, it will again get converted into the liquid and you will get it. So first of all, we will vaporize it by heating it, so the liquid and the solid which we had mixed together, this liquid will get converted into vapor. Now these vapor will reaches to the condenser, where there is temperature is low, again it will get converted into the droplets, into the solvent again, and then it can be taken into a collector. So at first we will having the solid. In one of the flask we are having solid, and in the other flask we are having the liquid. So we can collect both of them, we will get both of them, that is the solid one as well as that of the liquid one, students. Okay, so I hope you have understood here that how and where we are going to use the process of a distillation. I told you here one more thing, that the process of a distillation is not only for the solid and the liquid, but we can also separate the two liquids also from each other, but their boiling point should be, the difference between the boiling point should be large. Then we have started and tried to understand that how can we separate the two liquid components from each other. It means if a mixture is there and that mixture is consisting of two liquids in it. So how can we separate the two liquids from each other? So first of all, we will take that of the fractional distillation, and the second one is by using the separating funnel. So these two are the method by which we are able to separate them. Now the question arises here that the liquids are of different types. So if we look at the type of the liquid, so there are liquid which can be mixed with each other easily, and there are liquid which cannot be mixed with each other easily. So the liquid which can be mixed with each other, they are known as miscible liquid. And the liquid which cannot be mixed with each other, they are called as the immiscible liquid. Okay, so immiscible Okay, so one mixed with each other and the other one do not mixed with each other. This was about that of the miscible and immiscible liquid. Now, how can we separate? If suppose we have taken one miscible liquid, it means we have taken the two liquids which are miscible, immiscible with each other, and we have taken two liquids which are miscible to each other. So, what are the different separating techniques that we are going to use to separate the miscible liquids and that of the immiscible liquid? So before that, we go and try to understand the things in detail. Let me tell you that since in the immiscible liquid they do not mix with each other, here we are going to use that of the method, and that is known as the separating funnel. Okay, so separating funnel. This method or this equipment will help in separating that of the two miscible liquid, immiscible liquid with each other. And in case of a miscible liquid, what we will use? We will going to use that of the fractional distillation. So I hope you have understood that how can we separate the two components. If it is the two liquids are there, first of all we will going to see that whether the two liquids which is present in the mixture, they can be mixed with each other or not. Means they are easily mixed with each other or not. Means either they are a miscible liquid or not. Or if it is a miscible liquid, if they mix with each other well, then we are going to use to separate both of them through the process of a fractional distillation. And if they do not mix with each other, it means if there is a separating boundary is there between that of the two liquids, so instead of using that of the fractional distillation, we will prefer the separating funnel, which is much easier than that of the fractional distillation to separate both of them. Okay, so this is the method by which we can separate the immiscible liquid and that of the miscible liquid also. Now let us see that how we used to perform that of the fractional distillation, or we are going to use that of the separating funnel. Means what are the different the process by which we are going to use these two methods. Now let us see, students, that if I will start with that of the fractional distillation. Fractional distillation. So here, first of all, we will write it that fractional distillation is that method, it is that process by which we used to separate the two miscible liquids from each other. Okay, so we can write it that it is a process by which we can separate the two or more miscible liquids, from each other. Okay, two or more miscible liquids from each other. Okay, so here the distillate that we will get means there must be the difference in their temperature, totally depend upon the boiling point. Okay, so we can write it that the distillate is what, student? Distillate is that which when you heat it and then when you heat it becomes boiled, means converted into vapor, and finally will in the condenser get converted into the liquid and you can collect it. So that distillate is that which we get through the condenser is the distillate. Okay, or we can say that the substance which we are going into which we are going to show the do the process of a distillation is the distillate. Okay, so the distillate being collected, which we use to collect it, collected in fraction, boiling at different temperature. It means, what is the meaning of this boiling at different temperature? So the meaning of that is, student, that they must differ from each other through their boiling point. It means their boiling should be at a different temperature. Means when you provide heat to it, when you provide temperature to it, it will boil, it should boil at a different temperature. Okay. So we can say that the separation of the two liquids from each other depend upon the fractional distillation process will depend upon their boiling point. Okay. So the separation of two liquids by fractional distillation depends upon the difference of their boiling point. Okay, so the distillation process, the fractional distillation process which we are going to use, it should be at a difference in the boiling point here. Now you see, student, when we are going to use this process, means what happened in this fractional distillation. Now you see, student, the question arises in your mind is that this is the distillation method, this is the distillation, and here it is written fractional. And just before that, we already had studied about the distillation process. So what is the difference here between that of the fractional distillation and that of distillation? So in case of a distillation process, we use a simple distillation set in which we use to boil that of the mixture, and that is the condenser which is connected with it. But in case of a fractional distillation, there is a tube that is known as a fractionating column is there, and this fractionating column. Okay, so here we are going to use a simple fractionating column. Now, what is there in that of the fractionating column? So, in that fractionating column, beads are present. What is the role of the beads in that of the fractionating column? So, basically, when you provide heat to that of the mixture, the first of all mixture, it means which consisting of both the liquid. Now what we have done here, student, we have taken the mixture, and with the mixture we have connected the fractionating column in which we put the beads in it. And this fractionating column is connected to the condenser. Now you see, when you provide a sufficient amount of a heat to that of the mixture, the liquid mixture, what will happen? The liquid which is having low boiling point, it will evaporate first. Okay, and then as it will evaporate faster, it will reaches to the fractionating column where there are the beads. okay, and when it goes through towards that of the beads, it will produces a lot of hindrance, and due to which it finally becomes cools down and goes to the liquid mixture again, to the flask in which we have taken the mixture again, and there already heat is supplying to it, so again it will get evaporated. So what will happen with this, students, that the liquid which is having a low temperature, because as it reaches to the flask after condensing, it will again come back in the form of a vapor. So it will go first to that of the condenser, and finally from there we can collect it into the RB flask. Okay, so let me write it, and it will make the things very much clear to you people. And that is, so if suppose the students that this is a test tube stand, and here we have taken a RB flask, and this flask is, in this one we have taken all that of the liquid mixture. Okay, the liquid mixture is present here, and through this what we have done here, we have, suppose this is a cork which is present in that of the vessel. Now through this tube is connected, students. Okay, and this tube is what? Through this tube, you will see the thermometer is attached with it. Okay, so thermometer. Now, this tube is consisting of the beads in it. Okay, it is consisting of beads in it, and finally through that a condenser is there, students. Okay, now this is what, through which one pipe is there, which is an inlet pipe, and this is an outlet pipe is there, and it is filled with the water. So this is a liquid mixture, students, and if it is a thermometer, so and here we will keep a on another beaker. Either you can take it. Okay, so here we have taken another kind of a beaker, and through which the liquid is coming. Okay, so basically you see, student, this is what, it is a condenser. This is what, this is a fractionating column. And this is a liquid mixture. So you see, students, that when this liquid mixture is boiled, when it is boiled, it will heat, and in the form of a vapor it will reach it. This is what, this is the beads which is present in that of the fractionating column. So when you will boil, what will happen, the liquid, one of the liquid which is having the less boiling point will reaches to the fractionating column where the beads are there, and these beads will act as a hindrance, so it will finally come back to the flask again. Okay, now due to the continuous supply of the heat, again it will goes back to the, in the form of a vapor, it will reaches to the beads, and finally after coming and going to the beads again, it will reaches to the condenser. So from here this vapor it will reaches to the condenser, and in the condenser, since the supply of the water is there, so it will becomes converted into the solvent, from the vapor converted to the liquid again, and then we will collect that of the liquid which is having less boiling point at this collector first. Okay, so this we will call as a pure liquid component. When we are going to use this fractionating column, when both the liquids are miscible with each other, this is the first one, and the second one that we use, that the difference in boiling point is less than 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, so the difference in the boiling point is less than the 25 degrees Celsius. So fractional distillation is one student in which the two liquids and the boiling point between them will be less than that of a 25 degrees Celsius. If it is more than the 25 degrees Celsius, then we can use simple distillation method and we can separate them from each other. But if suppose we want to separate the liquid which are miscible and their boiling point are very close to each other, it means they are less than that of a 25 degrees Celsius. So what we will going to use in place of that, we are going to use the fractionating distillation, in which the main thing that we have to understand, that there is a fractionating column. This fractionating column consisting of the beads, and which you can say that provide it that of the liquid which is having low boiling point to the condenser, means it will make the liquid which is having low boiling point reach first to that of the condenser, and then the liquid which is having a more boiling point, it will come later. Okay, so this was about that of the fractional distillation. Is there any example in the students due to which we are able to understand here? Yes. So the example is alcohol and water.
Alcohol and
water. So the
boiling point of alcohol is 78 degrees Celsius, and the boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius.
So you can see here that the difference in the boiling point is 22 degrees Celsius, so which is less than that of a 25 degrees Celsius. So ultimately, the method that we are going to use to separate the alcohol and water from each other is the fractional distillation. You see, students, that alcohol and water are the miscible to each other. So this is the first point, and the second point, that their boiling point is less than that of a 25 degrees Celsius. So we are going to use the fractionating distillation for it to separate them from each other. Okay.
So here, first one we will write it, that alcohol and water are miscible, and their boiling point is less than 25 degrees.
Okay, so this was about the first case in which that is the liquid which is having the which mix with each other, or which we can say are miscible with each other. Let us move on and see that what are the different application of the fractional distillation. Applications. So the first application is that it is used to separate the mixtures of the miscible liquid in the laboratory also. Okay, like alcohol and water is there, so we are able to separate it with the help of the fractionating column. The second one is, which is important, that it is used to separate the crude petroleum. Separate crude oil petroleum. Such as petrol, kerosene, natural gas, diesel. Diesel is also there. Diesel. Okay. Then it is also used to separate gases from air. Okay, so this method is also used to separate the gases from the air. Basically what happened, the different gases is, first of all, it is liquefied. You know that the gases are liquefied by applying a pressure on it. So when we will apply a pressure on it, it will get converted into the liquid. And since they get converted into the liquid, except that of the carbon dioxide, because when you apply a pressure on the carbon dioxide, it will get converted into the solid carbon dioxide. Okay, so we will say that the carbon dioxide will get converted into solid, and we will take the dry ice again, dry ice, we will separate it. And then when you liquefy the nitrogen, oxygen and helium also in the form of a liquid, after forming it into the liquid, these liquid are again miscible to each other, so we can separate them on the basis of their boiling point. Okay, then the next one is that is, how can we separate the two immiscible liquid from each other, and the process is the separating point. The process is separating funnel. Now, how can you separate the two separating? Normally, what happens here, students? If suppose example is water is there and kerosene, okay, or petrol and water is there. Petrol and water is there. Okay. Benzene, ether is there. These all are immiscible liquid. So what we are going to do first? At first, suppose we have taken that of the water and kerosene. So we will take both of them in that of the separating funnel, and we will shake it so that they will get thoroughly mixed with each other. Although they will not going to mix, it means we are simply using it so that they got physically they will get mixed with each other. Okay. So after kerosene and water we have taken in the separating funnel, now what we will do is that we will take that separating funnel and we will stand it. We will keep it on the iron stand. Okay. So when you left it on the iron stand, what will happen? Then you will find that the liquid which is having the higher density will be present at the lower, and the liquid which is having the lower density, it means which is lighter, it will remain present at the upper layer, as an upper layer. Okay. So if this is the oil, so just below to that, this will be that of the water, and you will find that there is the separation boundary itself explained about that, how they differ from each other. So if it is a oil, student, so it is having the low density, so it will remain floating on the upper surface, and water being the higher density, it will present at the lower portion. So when they get separated, after keeping it for a few interval of a time, when it gets separated then, what we will find here, students, that with the help of a stopcock, in a separating funnel there is a stopcock. When you open that of the stopcock, then first of all, because water is present at the lower end, so we will separate the water first, and then we can in one beaker, and then in the another one we can separate that of the oil. So by this method we can separate the two immiscible liquid from each other. Okay, so this was about that of the separating funnel. Okay, you can take any of these, oil or water is there, or if you take benzene or ether or water or kerosene, we have to do the same method, taking them in that of the separating funnel and keep it left under stir for some time by putting it on an iron stand, okay, only with the help of the iron stand, and it is having a stopcock at the bottom of the separating funnel. When there is a formation of the two layer of the liquids, which is having the higher density and the lower density at the upper portion, we will open the stopcock and take out the liquid which is having higher density present at the lower end, and then in the another one we will separate the liquid which is having the lower density, or which is the lighter and floating on the another liquid. Okay, by this we are going to separate the separating funnel, separate the two liquids, two immiscible liquid from each other with the help of the separating funnel.